So let's get started and welcome again to our class, guys. This is the learning experience number 9. Today we're going to work on the activity number 3 and activity number 4. Ya vamos a trabajar en dos actividades, actividad número 3 y 4, con la finalidad de ahorrar un poco, una semana, ¿no? Para también hacer la parte de speaking. Okay, so yeah. This is the activity number one, number three, which is called our anniversary. Yes, our anniversary. Okay, so you know, guys, that this year, no, este año, Peru is celebrating the bicentennial. No, está celebrando el bicentenario. So this is a very important year. Yes, this is our anniversary of 200 years of independence. So here we have an exercise, something to do, and it says write two examples for each category. ¿Ya? Tenemos que escribir dos ejemplos para cada categoría. What categories do we have? First of all, we have food. Food. What's the meaning of food, guys? ¿Qué era food? What is it? ¿Qué significa food?
Comida,
yes, very good. So, first of all, we're gonna write two examples of food. And here we have, yes, examples. Pollo a la brasa. That is an example. Es un ejemplo, so we have to write more. Vamos a escribir más. Then we have another category, which is music. Music. Landmarks. Landmarks. And finally, celebration. Celebration. Okay? So, yeah, guys, let's get started. What other foods, other Peruvian foods do you know? A ver, ¿qué otros platos o comidas peruanas conocen? A ver, could you tell me, please?
Ceviche.
Yes, we cannot forget it. Yes, no podemos olvidarnos del ceviche. What else? ¿Qué más? Pollo a la brasa, no, because it's already there. Ya está ahí, pollo a la brasa. Another one.
Papa la huancaína.
Papa la huancaína, wow. Yes, we have a lot, right? Tenemos muchos platos, ¿no? Yeah, very good, guys. So those are two examples, son dos ejemplos. Si ustedes desean escribir otros ejemplos, okay, do it. Yes, music.
El guayno, mi.
Ajá, guayno, very good. Another one.
La música criolla.
Yes, excellent. Ajá, música criolla, ¿no? O Creole music. Okay, let's write it like this. Música criolla. Ajá. What else? Landmarks. Which one is the most important landmark that we have here in Peru? This is one that is in Cusco. What is it? Ajá, yes. Yes, that very good. Machu Picchu. What else? Another. What else, guys? Any other? A ver, ¿qué más, chicos? This is Machu Picchu. How? I just confused. Okay. Another one, guys. Do you remember any other? No more? Nada más? No. Sorry?
Miss, ¿podría ser el Señor de los Milagros?
Señor de los Milagros is not a landmark. It's like... It would be a celebration. No, sería una celebración, ¿no? But landmarks are places, son lugares, los landmarks, places, patrimonios. So, do you have any other place? Nothing? I would say, for example, Nazca Lines.
Yo conozco uno.
Ah, yeah, tell me. Which one is it?
El Puerto Pizarro, Miss. Es un lugar
Excellent. Look at that. Yes, Puerto Pizarro. Wow, we have to visit that place, ¿no? Tenemos que visitar. Hay muchos lugares en nuestro país que no conocemos, quizás no son tan conocidos, pero son hermosos, ¿no? Y muy bien. Excelente. Thank you. Chalianita. Next, celebrations. Celebrations.
Al Señor de los Milagros.
Ajá, Señor de los Milagros, ok. What else? Any other? What else, guys?
Celebración de la música criolla.
Ajá, sí, puede ser, yes. Música criolla, ¿no? Música criolla celebration. Ok, very good. Yes, ajá. Ya está. Ok. Royal Music Celebration. Yes, ok. That is pretty good. Pretty good. So, yeah. Those are the categories that we have. Food, music, landmarks, and celebrations. Very good, guys. Excellent. Now, here we have what I told you. We have a listening comprehension exercise. So, we have an audio. Tenemos un audio. And what are we going to do? It says, listen to the to three presentations. Acá está mal escrito. Listen to three presentations, stations, and match the person with the information. Entonces, acá tenemos a las personas. We have three people. They are Carlos, Karen, and Francisco. So, we're going to match. Yes, vamos a relacionar a las personas con la información. For example, here we already have Carlos from Cerro de Pasco, that's where he is from. Anniversary is in October, okay. Beautiful landmarks. So that is the information about it. So we have to listen to the information about Karen and Francisco, okay? So let's pay attention, guys.
PA1. Activity 3. Our anniversary. Let's practice. Listening comprehension. Practice. Exercise 1. Listen to three presentations and match the person with the information.
Hello, friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Carlos. I'm from Cerro de Pasco. The anniversary is in October. I'm proud of Cerro de Pasco for the beautiful landmarks like the Bosque de Piedras de Huayay. Come and visit my city.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Karen, and I'm from Chachapoyas. The anniversary of my city is in September. I'm very proud of Chachapoyas. I'm proud of the amazing landmarks like the Gocta Falls. You have to come and visit.
Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Francisco, and I'm from the beautiful Ayacucho. Our anniversary is in April, and it's a very important day for us. I'm proud of Ayacucho for the fantastic traditions, like carnivals and processions. You can participate in them too.
This is the...
Okay, guys. Very good. So, do you have the answers? Do you already have the answers? Do you want to listen to it again? ¿Tienen las respuestas o escuchamos nuevamente, chicos? What do you think?
Me, lo del final.
Okay, okay, we listen to it again. Yeah, no problem, it's okay. Okay, guys, so do you have the answers now? Do you have the answers? ¿Tienen las respuestas? Yes?
Sí,
ya. Okay. Yes, yeah, we're gonna match, ya. Vamos a relacionar. Yeah. Let me take up a color. So tell me, Karen. Let's see, Karen. Where is Karen from?
Chachapoyas.
Oh, yeah. She's from Chachapoyas. Okay, you can draw these lines. Pueden dibujar las líneas así. What else? What else, guys? ¿Qué más? When is the anniversary of Chachapoyas?
En septiembre. La.
September, yes. September, okay, let's match it then.
September.
Aha, September. Excellent, very good. Now, why is this person proud of Chachapoyas? Because of the amazing landmarks. Excellent. Yeah, very good. Amazing landmarks. Okay, there's a person here. Yeah, let's continue. Okay, how about the other person? Francisco. Where is Francisco from?
Ayacucho.
Yes, Francisco is from Ayacucho. There we have it.
Ayacucho.
Yes, very good. Now, when is the anniversary of Ayacucho?
Tradition.
No, the anniversary.
Anniversary
in April. Yeah, very good. Excellent. No problem. Okay. And why is Francisco proud of Ayacucho?
Tradition.
Aha, because of the fantastic traditions. Aha, yes, very good. You did it excellent. Very good, guys. Congratulations. Now, once we finish that, we have here another part, which is true or false. True or false, yes? So let's mark true or false. De acuerdo a lo que hemos escuchado from the audio, yes, del audio, okay? Number one, the anniversary of Cerro de Pasco is in October. True or false? Cerro de Pasco.
Claro.
That is true. Yes, excellent. Yes, very good. That's true. Next. Karen is very proud of Chachapoyas.
True.
Yes, excellent. Next. The anniversary of Ayacucho is in September.
True.
Ayacucho, yes, is in April. Yes, April. Aha, so that is false. Very good. Next. The Bosque de Piedras de Huayay is in Cerro de Pasco.
True.
You sure? ¿Todos de acuerdo? Is it true? Bosque de Piedras de Huayay is in Cerro de Pasco. So true or false? You don't decide, guys. Todavía no veo que no se ponen de acuerdo. Yeah, it's true. Very good. It's true. Yes. Excellent. Very good. And the final, the last one, it says Francisco is proud of the Gocta Fall.
True. Sí, sí.
True. Okay.
Sí, por supuesto.
Okay, are you sure, guys?
False, me.
False. Who is proud of the Gocta Fall? Who is proud? ¿Quién está orgulloso o orgullosa?
Karen.
Karen, yes. Yeah, very good. Excellent. So, guys, let's continue here. Thank you. We have another, this is exercise number 2, and it says complete the text with the correct words from the box. So here, guys, we have some words. For example, friendly, proud, anniversary, day, in, amazing. So we're gonna use those words. Vamos a utilizar estas palabras to complete this paragraph, yeah? Para completar este párrafo, this text. Okay, so it says, hi, my name is Marta and I am from Tumbes. I love my city. The
anniversary.
Okay. Let's complete it. Let's see if that is correct. The anniversary Wait, I can't copy this, I think. Está. The anniversary of Tumbes is... What's missing here? This is January. What is missing here? The anniversary of Tumbes is January. What's missing here? Just a small word, una pequeña palabra. Para decir en enero. What's missing?
In.
Ajá. Before a month, antes de un mes, siempre decimos in, ¿no? Para que diga en, ¿no? The anniversary of Tumbes is in January. Okay, very good. I am very... of my city. I am very, dice, yo estoy muy de mi ciudad. I am very...
orgulloso.
Uh-huh. ¿Y cómo digo orgulloso? A ver, which one is orgulloso? Which word? Proud. Yes. I am very proud. Yes, I am very proud of my city. Okay? I am proud of, dice, soy orgulloso de, I am proud of, en este caso sería orgullosa, ¿no? Because it's Marta. I am proud of natural beauty. Estoy orgullosa de belleza natural. An article is missing. Of the amazing natural beauty. No, chicos, acá simplemente falta la palabra de. The natural beauty. Es un artículo. Estoy orgulloso de la belleza de la, ¿no? La, de. Belleza natural. Like the beautiful Punta Sal Beach. I'm proud of the... Estoy orgullosa de... I am proud of the... Ahí sí va una palabra, un adjetivo. Landmarks.
Amazing.
Yes, I am proud of the amazing landmarks and people, dice. Y personas. And... un adjetivo que describa a las personas.
Friendly.
Yes, amigables, ¿no? Friendly. And friendly people. That is it. Yeah, we did it. Yes. If we read it, si lo leemos, obviamente va a tener sentido, ¿no? Dice, hi, my name is Marta. I'm from Tumbes. I love my city. The anniversary of Tumbes is in January. I am very proud of my city. And I am... proud of the natural beauty, like the beautiful Punta Sal Beach. I am proud of the amazing landmarks and friendly people. Come and visit. Excellent, guys. Very good. We have it. So here we finish this activity number 3. No, terminamos acá la actividad número 3 y simplemente evaluamos si es que somos capaces de realizar estas actividades, ¿no? Por ejemplo, estos ejercicios. Si podemos reconocer palabras simples cuando las escuchamos en inglés, ¿no? Del audio. Si podemos comprender palabras familiares que escuchamos en un texto breve y sencillo en inglés. ¿Ok? Ahora, once we do it, we continue with the activity number 4, ¿ya? Actividad número 4, which is I love Peru. ¿Yes? So here, guys, we have... hello, Leonardito, tell me.
La actividad 5, ¿qué dijo que se iba a hacer?
No, en la actividad 5, o sea, la próxima semana, vamos a realizar el reto, the challenge, ¿no es cierto? Que ya sabemos que nuestro reto es elaborar un póster en el cual vamos a mencionar esos motivos por los cuales estamos orgullosos de nuestro Perú. ¿Ok? Entonces, de nuestro país. Entonces, chicos, chicas, nos preparamos para ello, ¿no? Con estas actividades que estamos haciendo, nos estamos preparando para la próxima semana poder realizar nuestro reto. ¿Ya? Y la semana que continúa, a la próxima, estaríamos haciendo speaking. ¿Ya? Bien.
¿Qué es speaking, profesora?
Speaking, Leonardito, es hablar, ¿no? Entonces vamos a hablar, vamos a evaluar speaking, vamos a ver cómo hacen ustedes también, cómo pronuncian, como hicimos en la experiencia de aprendizaje número 8. Recuerdan que ustedes, cada uno por aquí vino en el Meet y hizo su presentación, ¿no? De manera oral, ¿no? Es una presentación oral, es speaking, ¿ok? So, is it clear, Leonardo?
Okay,
¿está claro? Ok, thank you. So now let's continue. It says activity number 4. I love Peru. Okay, here we have a matching activity. Vamos a tenemos una actividad de relacionar. Here we have picture A. Miren la imagen A. B, C, D, E. So we're gonna match. Yes, for example. Here we have an example. It says language. Language, letter C. Language means idioma, which is letter C, because this person is saying hi, right? Number one, people.
D.
D, yes, very good. So this is, yes, I cannot write it, I think. Okay, let me try this. Yeah, letter D. Okay, very good. Number two, foot.
B.
B, excellent. Next, music.
E.
E. And finally, landmark.
A.
A. Okay, very good. Yes, awesome. Now let's continue here, guys. We have something else, yeah? So look at this. It says, listen to and read the poster. So guys, here we have a poster. Remember that next week we are going to elaborate a poster, ¿no? Recuerden que la próxima semana vamos a hacer un poster. Por lo tanto, acá tenemos un ejemplo, miren, ¿no? So this is an example, okay? So let's pay attention. What do we have to do here? We have to read it. So for example, we're going to talk about, as we are Peruvian, ¿no? Como somos peruanos, we are going to talk about our country, ¿no? Peru. But for example, here, just as an example, this is a person who is from Brazil, yes? And he says, for example, this is a girl, proud of my country, Brazil. In our case, en nuestro caso, nosotros diremos, proud of my country, Peru. Yes, so here, guys, we're going to listen to the audio. Vamos a escuchar el audio que nos van a leer esta información. Yeah, let's pay attention. And this is about Brazil, right?
Learning experience 9. This is Peru. English level pre-A1. Activity 4. I love Peru. Let's listen and read. Listen to and read the poster.
Proud of my country, Brazil. The anniversary of Brazil is in September. I love the delicious food, like feijoada. I'm proud of the famous carnival. It is in February. I'm proud of Brazilian soccer players, like Ronaldinho. I like Brazil's beautiful language, Portuguese. I'm proud of the rich culture. We have wonderful traditional music, dances, and more.
Okay, guys. So, yeah. There we have information. So, this is exactly what we have to do the next week. Something like this. But, of course, we're going to talk about Peru, no? Ya tenemos aquí un ejemplo de lo que vamos a hacer la próxima semana, pero pues nosotros hablaremos de nuestro país, ¿no? So here, guys, there are some mistakes I don't know if you've noticed. Por ejemplo, en la escritura de algunos meses está mal. This is not September, it's September, ¿no? B-E-R. Si es que acá lo escribieron mal, sorry. For example, here we're going to mention, ¿no? Tenemos que mencionar, por ejemplo, when's the anniversary of our country, ¿no? ¿Cuándo es el aniversario de nuestro país? So, for example, it says, the anniversary of Brazil is in September, okay? it's also talking about the food, ¿no? Está hablando de la comida, for example. It says, I love the delicious food like feijoada. Right? Ya está, ¿no? What else? It says, ¿no? The music. Look at this. The festival, right? I am proud of the famous carnival. It is in February, ¿no? Conocemos el carnaval bastante famoso from Brazil. What else? The soccer. Look at this. I am proud of Brazilian soccer players like Ronaldinho. Mm-hmm. And also the language. Miren el idioma, ¿no? I like Brazil's beautiful language, Portuguese. And finally, it says, I am proud of the rich culture. We have wonderful traditional music, dances, and more. Okay? So, yeah. This person is talking about those things that she's proud of. Yes, those things that makes her proud of her country, ¿no? Esas cosas que le hacen a ella orgullosa de su país, ¿no? Y acá tenemos algunas palabritas, miren, que tenemos que tener en cuenta, ¿no? Por ejemplo acá, Brazil's, belonging to Brazil, ¿no? Que pertenece a Brasil, ¿no? Entonces, esta palabra, por ejemplo, cuando nosotros ponemos un sustantivo y le agregamos un apóstrofe y ese quiere decir que algo le corresponde, ¿no? Algo le corresponde a esta persona, en este caso a este país. Brazil's, en este caso sería de Brasil, ¿no? Brazil's, de Brasil. Y acá lo tenemos, miren, ve. I like Brazil's beautiful language. Dice, me gusta el idioma hermoso de Brasil. Brazil's beautiful language, ¿ok? Y, por ejemplo, nosotros adaptándolo a nuestro país sería, por ejemplo, I like, for example, ¿no? Yo diría, I like Peru's beautiful language, ¿no? Me gusta el hermoso idioma de Perú. Peru's beautiful language. ¿Qué más? Tenemos también, hemos encontrado acá dentro del póster, la palabra Brazilian. Means from Brazil, ¿no? De Brazil. So this is the nationality, ¿no? Es la nacionalidad. It's like saying Brazil... Brazilian, ¿no? Brasil, brasileño o brasileña. Peruvian, peruano, peruana, ¿no? From Peru, ¿ya? So don't forget that. So that is the poster, guys, and here we have a reading comprehension exercise. Ya vamos a hacer este ejercicio de comprensión lectora. For example, the anniversary of Brazil Carnival, it's in February. Okay, acá está, bueno, it's in February. Yes, the anniversary of Brazil is in February. That is the correct one. Yes, ya está, así uniríamos. That is not correct, guys. Incluso acá está mal. When is the anniversary of Brazil, guys? A ver, vamos a corregir esa parte. When is the anniversary of Brazil?
September.
Entonces, ¿cuál sería la correcta?
La E.
Letter E. Entonces, acá vamos a corregir, ¿ya? Vamos a corregir porque no sé qué pasó, pero esta vez está muy mal escrito todo acá. Bien, so this is letter E. Y está. Corregimos. Esto de acá lo vamos a dejar porque esto va con esta parte de acá. It's in September. Ya está. Ya, chicos. Bien. Seguimos. A ver, let's continue. Let's do it well. Vamos a corregir, ¿no? Es lo importante, que cuando vamos aprendiendo somos capaces de corregir mistakes, errores, ¿ya? Ya está. I love the delicious. ¿Qué decía la persona? I love the delicious
food like
feijoada. Yes, food like feijoada. Okay, unimos. Number two, letter F. Mm-hmm. Number three, I am proud of the famous. I am proud of the famous. A ver, vayamos arriba. ¿En qué parte dice I am proud of the famous? Miren acá. I am proud of the famous carnival. It is in February. I am proud of the famous. Recién estaba con la letra C. Yes, acá. Number three, letter C. Do you agree? ¿Están de acuerdo, chicos? Do you?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Okay, very good. Number four, I like the beautiful. I like the beautiful. Nothing. A ver, vamos a ver arriba. No se preocupen, no se preocupen. I like the beautiful.
Language.
Yes, idioma. I like the beautiful language, Portuguese. Hey, very good. Yes, that. Mm-hmm. Next, I am proud of the rich. I am proud of the rich culture. Yes, we have wonderful traditional music, dances, and more. Yes, very good. So, yeah, this one, letter D. Next, the last one. I am proud of the excellent.
Soccer players
like Ronaldinho. Okay, excellent, guys. Letter B. Ya, no se olviden, chicos, de corregir los errores, the mistakes. Ya, okay. Ya está, thank you. Very good, guys. Excellent, we did it. Lo hicimos, muy bien. Now, let's continue here. We have another exercise, and it says match the parts of a poster. Okay, so guys, this is gonna help us to our next class, no? Nos va a ayudar bastante para nuestra próxima clase, because we have to elaborate a poster next class. And so, what are the parts of a poster? ¿Cuáles son las partes de un poster? Information, title, and pictures. Ya, tiene que tener información, título e imágenes. Y bueno, vamos a ubicar esas partes. For example, all the number ones, todos los número unos, number ones, ¿qué será eso? This is title, ¿no? Es un título, ¿ok? Number one is a title. We just have one, solo tenemos uno. Bien, next. All the number two, yes, number twos, los números dos, ¿qué son?
Pictures.
Pictures, yes. Entonces acá pondremos pictures. Ya está. And how about number three?
Information.
Excellent. Ya está. Very good. So that's what we have to take into consideration for the next week. Our poster must have information, title, pictures. Or title, pictures, information, whatever, ¿ya? Those are the three parts. Obviamente, nuestro título irá enfocado, pues, en nuestro país, ¿no? I love Peru, I am proud of Peru, yes? In the information, you're going to talk about those things that makes you proud of Peru, ¿no? Todas esas cosas que te hacen orgulloso u orgullosa de tu país. Y finalmente, pictures, ¿no? Imágenes relacionadas. For example, the food, the landmarks, I don't know, the music, yes, whatever. Bien, chicos, so that is what we have to take into consideration. And that is it, guys. Es todo lo que tenemos para esta actividad número 4. Únicamente tenemos que prestar bastante atención en cómo elaborar nuestro póster e ir pensando, ¿no? Por ahí, ¿cuáles son todas esas cosas que nos hacen orgullosos de nuestro país? Y bueno, vamos a evaluar nuestro aprendizaje de esta actividad. Si, por ejemplo, podemos reconocer palabras y frases sencillas y familiares escritas en inglés. Y si podemos reconocer palabras sencillas y están respaldadas por imágenes. ¿Ya? So, guys, that is it. Yes.